receive with feelings of greatest happiness and emotion that I send you my greetings. In the birthday of the independence and sovereign states of God, it marks the fulfillment of the destiny of the Muslim nation.
It made great sacrifices in the past few years to have its homeland. At this supreme moment, my thoughts are with those alien fighters
in our call, who readily sacrificed all they had in during their lives to make Pakistan possible. Let me assure them that Pakistan would remain grateful to them and cherish the memory of those who are no more. The creation of the new state has placed a tremendous responsibility on the citizens of Pakistan. It gives them an opportunity to demonstrate to the world how a nation containing many elements can live in peace and amity and work for the betterment of all its citizens irrespective of caste or creed. Our object should be peace within and peace without. We want to live peacefully and maintain cordial, friendly relations with our immediate neighbors and with the world at large. We have no aggressive designs against anybody. We stand by the United Nations Charter and will gladly make our full contribution to peace and prosperity of the world. This day marks the end of a poignant phase in our national history, and it should also be the beginning of a new and a noble era. Let us impress the minorities by our word, deed and thought that as long as they fulfill their duties and obligations as loyal citizens of Pakistan, they have nothing to fear. To the states beyond our borders, we send our greetings and assure them that Pakistan will extend to them its most friendly cooperation in preserving peace. We have no ambition beyond the desire to live honorably and let others live honorably. Finally, let me tell you, fellow citizens, Pakistan is a land of great potential resources, but to build it up into a country worthy of the Muslim nation, which will require every ounce of energy that we possess. And I'm confident that it will come from all